I get a lot of questions every year about how to get stuck sleds out, and I think it's something that through time you learn, but each stuck is different. So today I'm going to talk a little bit about how to get this stuck out, which isn't really a bad one, but it could be worse if I didn't dig it out right. So watch me, and I'm going to give you a few pointers on how to get a certain sled out from a certain type of stuck. The advantage of this particular stuck is that the sled is not at a perfect 90 degree with the hill. If you notice, the sled is slightly kiltered off to the side, which makes it easier for me because I know that's the way I want the sled to tip, shorter distance. Either way, I'm going to show you a little bit about digging out what I call a fan, which would be describing this side right here. We're going to fan this out with the shovel a little bit, and it'll be a lot easier to tip the sled over. I might be able to drag this sled off without actually flipping it, but I am by myself, and that's really what these videos are about, is how to do this successfully by yourself without exerting too much energy. So keep watching, and watch me dig. So first things first, I got my shovel out and ready to dig. Since I've done this quite a few times, I do know that you will get very hot when you're digging. So I will take my coat off, and I suggest you probably want to do the same, because when you're all sweaty and you start to ride again, it's going to be a lot colder. So get rid of the coat. Make sure you put your helmet and your coat off to the side to where whenever you do take off out of here, you don't throw a bunch of roost in it. Speaking from experience, by the way. So I'm going to start from the top of the sled down and work my way around to create a fan. Definitely the key is to get as low as you can to the platform of the track, because if you're trying to twist this sled over by yourself and you've got any resistance up against that track, you're just wasting your time. So best thing to do is start at the top, work your way down. That way you can clear the snow just one time.
You load 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. I was born one morning when the sun didn't shine. I picked up my shovel and I walked to the mine. I loaded 16 tons, a number 9 coal, and the straw boss said, well, to bless my soul.
You can see the advantage here that I've got now. I've dug the whole side of that track out. You can see it all the way down along that edge is exposed. That way when the sled is twisting over, it has no resistance pushing up against the skid or the rubber for that matter. So now I'm going to step into the next phase and try to tug this thing over to the side a little bit, the side that it's already tilted to on the face of the hill. So it should be a little easier on me. We'll see how it goes. The key to it, whenever you are unstuck and you've set yourself a platform in which to take off again on, don't be dainty on the gas. If you ease into it, you'll kick all the snow for your initial traction out the back, and you'll be stuck again. So when you go to take off, depending on your track length or your lug height of your sled, you want to grab a fistful. Make sure that you're pointed in a safe direction when you do it, and hold on, and as soon as you let off the gas, the sled will stop fairly easy in the soft snow. So watch me do it, and hopefully I'm successful. So as you can see, I held it pinned and rocked the sled around. I call it my gorilla dance, kind of just shake the heck out of it while you're holding the throttle wide open. And when she bites, you'll know it won't get out of your hands. Just let off the gas and let the sled shoot into a nice soft spot. Gear up and you're ready to go riding again. I'm glad I took the time to do a little extra digging, because it was kind of a little bit of a tough fight to get out of there, and I would have hated to have to do it all over again. So. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned something today. I've got a lot more videos coming up, so keep tuned. Like and subscribe if you would. I sure would appreciate it. My name's Joe with Four Wheel Riders Guiding out of the UP of Michigan.